Well, here at Only Motors, the producers have brought us to a car wash. I say us. John is actually in Andover and we're in Aldershot. I think it's near London. Being a northern lad, I wouldn't actually know where we are, to be honest. But we're at a car wash and I don't know what the plan is until John gets here, but as I'm here first, I'm going to try and work it so that John's washing cars and I'm sat in cars going through the car wash. So we'll just wait for John to get here and then we'll get things started. Let's groove on, cause it's time to move on. Here the drummer get wicked. Let's groove on, cause it's time to move on. Here the drummer get wicked. All right, so while no one's around, I'm taking the opportunity. I never thought I'd do this. Never particularly wanted to either, but I'm walking through a car wash and Tim's here. Tim.
All right, Beavis. Where's Butthead?
Okay. How come you're here?
Well, currently, I just happen to be reading about adjustable angle spray nozzles. You know, just like I like to keep my finger on the pulse. But, you know, would you like an ultimate wax, a work extreme, wash one, wash two, we'll give you a triple phone.
I thought you didn't like cars, but yet here you are sat in a car wash.
The thing is, I love car washes. To me, they're like supermarkets. I could possibly meet the woman of my dreams driving through as she's having a triple phone. You never know about these things. So, you know, well, John phoned me and he sort of said, you know, come down. Apparently we're doing something to do with car washing. So I thought, you know, a bit of extra cash.
Excellent. Well, where is John?
Well, he used his massive sized brain and ended up in Andover. As in, we're in Aldershot, he's in Andover. So, you know, what a quality car review that won't be, because he's supposed to be here. Well, I mean, as far as I'm aware, he wants to prove that car washes are the way forward, which I kind of agree with, because who the hell wants to spend, you know, hour and a half just cleaning the car? It's got to be the most dullest thing in the world.
I like washing my car. I do. It's therapeutic. And if you've got a nice car, it's nice to do a good job of it. And I think you can do a better job by hand than you can do by putting it through something like this.
Ah, I knew you'd be like that. I mean, I know, obviously, we Only Motors requires you big petrol head geeks, but you know, you're pushing that a bit too far. You spend an hour and a half on your car. I mean, you're kind of getting to that stage a bit like, you know, some of those American videos where they're, I love my car, this is my favorite angle. Well, all right, maybe I'm pushing it a bit too far, but
I sometimes spend 4 hours washing it.
4 hours? I don't know whether you're aware, right, but let me tell you about some of the statistics. In fact, let me tell you about some of the statistics. Apparently, 74% of people who go through a car wash feel much better when you know, they've had it done. 84% of people out of, I think it's the 24 to 34 age bracket, they often think that, you know, they feel much happier and pleasure that, you know, things have happened and their car's all beautiful and clean. And also, I don't know whether you're aware of this, right, but it's a little known fact that if you ask most people if they'd like to hand wash their car or send it through a proper car wash, they'd rather boil their own head than, you know, actually clean their own car. And talking of boiled heads,
he's here.
I'm not sure what just happened, but John's here. Let's go.
Ah! At least you know your alphabet, hey?
Oof.
Whoa!
What?
Where's the other proclaimer? And what's the problem?
Seriously, at a car wash, you're wearing that.
Look.
You'll get your sporran wet.
Let me tell you something.
It's the girl guides on the phone. They want their uniform back.
You're going to be washing that car over there by hand.
Oh, is it all this? Let me explain.
Right, you've been to Andover.
I've been to Andover, but car washes are wet, okay? The Highlands are wet.
Did you hand over your trousers?
Ah, funny boy. So, brogues were invented by the Scots because they were walking through muddy, wet bogs and the holes in the brogues let the water out.
This is even less relevant than eating burgers.
What's wearing a skirt got to do with it?
I knew today was going to be cold. I am wrapped in sheepskin.
Are you a true Scotsman?
This is wool. Am I a true Scotsman? I'm prepared.
Easy, I don't want to see past the ferry.
I'm paid enough to do that.
Right. You're going to be washing that car over there by hand.
What?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No.
I don't like washing cars.
Whoa. We had this discussion earlier, right? And he reckons that, you know, the best thing to do is to clean your own car with your own sponge and your own equipment and spend like an hour and a half, which is like ridiculous. Because here's another statistic for you, right? 3 months it will take in a whole lifetime you'll spend cleaning cars. You could be doing other stuff like, you know, going on a course or having the third of a baby. Not literally.
Getting some trousers.
Buying some trousers.
So you're going to wash the car
No,
and
so
prove
you
my
should
theory.
Do it. Because you should prove your own theory.
And you've got trousers already.
I know it works.
And he's got the kit to go through the car wash.
Kelt wins.
Okay, guys, this is the car. This is the company car.
Company car, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And if I'm going to be washing it,
so are you.
We're going to cut it down the middle. Cut it down the middle.
Hang on. One, as you all say, I know nothing about cars. And two, I don't want to wash it. I agree with his opinion.
It'll be just like washing your head, right?
You don't even know about water.
Yeah, right.
So you're what? You're going to do half each?
Yeah.
I'll tell you what we'll do. Here's a thing. I'll do the car wash, okay? And I'll see how many I can get through in an hour.
It's gonna take longer to clean that.
You've got an hour, okay?
Right.
That's an hour for a half a side each. I will go and put through, I don't know, 15, 20, maybe more.
Okay.
We'll work it at the car wash.
All right, Tim, an hour, let's go. Where do you get the coffee?
Well, I thought, you know, if it's gonna take an hour, I need some sustenance.
Oh, thanks.
Pew, 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 pew!
I'm not putting my hand in there. It's a dead rabbit.
Going for a wash. So, do you normally wash your car by hand? Or do you just have a little bit of rated?
I would literally come and let someone pay for someone to do it inside and out.
Okay. So you don't ever get involved in cleaning the car?
No,
you actually haven't got your own bucket and sponge and all that?
I used to do. When I first started driving, I used to love doing it myself, but now, unless my boyfriend does it for me.
Right, so we've got Joe here. Joe's just gonna put a big, dirty car through the wash, and this is really gonna test it.
Tim, I'm drawing a line down the roof. There we are, it's like colouring in.
So, as you can see, Land Rover Discovery, V6 diesel, covered, absolutely covered in grot. So we're just gonna follow this one in. So soapy bits being added just now, about halfway down. And it's all done on a chain driven action. So you actually park up the car. Essentially you stop everything, turn the engine off, and it drags you through. Hello darlings. Yes, we're here again at the other end, and now the epileptic octopus is having a go at Joe and taking all the water, taking all the wetness off, so we should have quite a dry Joe by the time we've finished. I've overdone the Joe jokes, haven't I really? Looks like we got a satisfied lady. Oh yeah!
Tim, I'll be back in a minute. Don't fall asleep. I've nearly finished my half.
Yeah, no, I've just got to touch it up a bit.
All right.
Seriously, I don't see the point of doing this. So, John. John, listen, this is taking ages and I really can't be bothered with it. He's nipped off somewhere, probably the loo or whatever.
Right.
Like shave his sideburns.
Uh-huh.
Let's take it through.
I'm loving the blab. to get you. That's the closest you've been to water for a long time.
I don't think I've ever been through a car wash before.
Oh, do you know what? I love it when they soap you up. That's my favourite bit.
This has got to be the most riveting thing of my life. What's all the blue stuff being sprayed on us?
That is something called SO Blue.
Whoa! We've gone all blue!
Smurfland!
It's like being back in the 60s, so I'm told.
Oh, it's bubblegum flavour. Can you smell that?
No. Oh, yeah?
Yeah, that's bubblegum right there.
It's like the Hubba Bubba of car washes.
Oh!
Do you know what? This is quite exciting. I don't know why. I must get out more.
So this is the brushy things.
Okay, this is where the brushes that clean the blue stuff off.
This is the elbow grease that you should have been using but weren't.
Yeah, but as I pointed out earlier, what is the point in wasting half your life cleaning a car when they have a big special brushy blue thing that does it for you?
I know, it's brilliant.
It doesn't do the inside though, does it? Because there's mini cheddars everywhere now.
Yeah.
We're on a track now.
Yeah, pretty much.
This is like the worst roller coaster ride ever.
Well, there wasn't really much point in today, was there? I've just spent the day washing a car.
No, I think we've proved a point. The reason I decided that we should take it through is because, well, I couldn't be asked to clean my side, but when you think about it, it shows off that, you know, it's much more fun to go through a car wash than to sit there with a massive sponge for an hour.
We had a blast. It was brilliant.
Yeah.
You don't care, do you?
I've got one thing to say, though, okay? They missed a bit.
Ah. But, Mr. Smarty Pants, you washed it first. So did you.
It was your side.
Let's go to the pub.
Luke, you are not my father!